Hi, and welcome to the show today. Today we're going to make buffalo wings. And I like to use Foster Farms. You can find it at some of the Walmarts. They're Foster Farm party wings. I've tried Tyson, Pilgrims. I like Foster Farms better because they're cut better. They're more Class A wings than the Outcasted Seconds, as some of the stores carry. So we've got our wings, and what it is, it's 2.5 pounds of chicken wings, and it comes frozen. And I've taken one bag, and I've put it in water in the refrigerator. Well, I guess it's been there about 5 hours, so it's pretty well thawed. We're going to put these back in the freezer. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and put those in a strainer. And we're going to let those sit here and drain while I talk about the sauce. So when we come back, I'm going to bring you up here and show you my take on a buffalo wing sauce and tell you a little bit about the classic buffalo wing sauce. So see you in a minute. Okay, the traditional buffalo wing sauce normally has Frank's Red Hot in it. And it normally has distilled white vinegar, some cayenne pepper, some garlic powder, butter or margarine, and that's a traditional buffalo wing sauce. But we're going to do it slightly different. We're going to use, instead of Frank's Red Hot, we're going to use Frank's Wing Red Hot. So we're going to go ahead and use this whole bottle. We're going to put it in our blender here. I guess that's probably 2 to 3 tablespoons in there. We're going to add a little bit. Let me go ahead and measure this. Oh, I got a glove on because I got a scratch on my hand. I want to get cayenne pepper in it. We're going to use 1/2 teaspoon of Worcestershire. We're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of cayenne. Let me wash this Worcestershire off. My oven's ready. We're going to deep fry and we're going to bake these wings. So 1/2 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. We don't want the sauce to be too overly spicy. And then we're going to add probably 1/2 cup of this sweet and tangy French dressing. But the kicker for Tom's buffalo sauce, oh, I forgot the garlic, hold on. We add 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder. Now the kicker for Tom's buffalo sauce is 2 tablespoons of apricot preserves. And that's why I've got it in the blender here, because I'm gonna stir up those apricot preserves. So if you wanted to do this orange chicken, you just use orange jam or preserves rather than the apricot. I like it a little bit with the French dressing and the apricot. It helps the buffalo sauce, I think, stand out a little bit better. Alright, we want to make sure all that apricot preserves is pureed. Alright, we're going to put that in our saucepan. Let me get a spoon. Alright, now we're going to put this on the stove. We're going to actually add our 2 tablespoons of butter. And we're going to put this on the stove and heat it up. So what we want is we want this butter to incorporate in this sauce. And that's going to be our wing sauce for our buffalo wings. All right, that's our wing sauce. Now, if you want to buy buffalo wing sauce, you can somewhere. But if you want to make it, so we're going to set that aside because we're going to coat our wings with it. We're going to bring you back around and show you how to do these wings. Okay, so our wings are washed and dried. And we're going to add a little salt. I guess it's about a quarter teaspoon. A little pepper. We're going to toss that around. And we're going to hit it with just a little bit of cayenne pepper. Now remember, this is buffalo wings, so we want them just a little spicy. That's why we didn't spice our sauce up too much. We want that little bit of cayenne. So it's probably an eighth of a teaspoon. It's not that much. And then we're going to take, let me open this up, about a half a tablespoon of oil, folks. And we're going to coat these wings with this oil, cayenne, and salt and pepper. Now that's all we're going to do to those wings before we dredge them in our wheat flour. So when we come back, I'll show you how to fry these wings up. Okay, I got super fine wheat flour. And what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to add about a cup and a half of this wheat flour in this little dish here. Hey, you know, you can put it in a bag and toss your wings. Or, I forgot, Little Miss Muffet got me, where is that at? She got me some Hooters buffalo wing. Or she got me some Hooters wing. Just wing breading. It's not buffalo, it's wing breading a while back. It's pretty good. It's got spices in it. And they use wheat flour too, but it's got wheat flour and spices and other stuff. But I really liked it. It was pretty good. So if you want to just get the Hooter breading, you can. So what we're going to do is, I'm going to go ahead and drop our basket in the deep fryer. Now I got the deep fryer set on 370 degrees. And if you want to know the oil mixture I use, you can go to my French fry video and see that I use Wesson's Best Blend canola oil and Crisco shortening. So we're just going to take and we're going to dredge these wings in this wheat flour. If you want to put them in a bag and shake them, you can. And we're just going to drop them in. Let me move this camera a little bit. I didn't have the camera loosened up. Now it'll move. So we're just going to drop them in to the deep fryer. We're going to cook those for about 7 minutes or so. We'll see how they look in about 7 minutes. And then we're going to finish them in the oven. And you know, you get on my videos and you see I like my chicken done. I don't like them raw. So if you don't like your chicken as done as I make my chicken and my other meats that I cook, just don't cook them as long. So we're just dredging these in that flour. They're already seasoned. If you shake them in a bag, you can put them in pretty much quicker than dredging them by themselves. All
Alright, so that's about, one more is about half. Got plenty of room in there. Put a couple more, actually. Alright, so we're going to cook those for about 7 minutes. Wash my hands here. Take a look at them. Oh, they're going to be great. Now, we got our oven set on 350, folks. Got the oven set on 350. My sauce is back here waiting. Probably going to cook these wings for about a half hour. I make sesame wings, orange wings. If you want to make some sesame wings, you can get you some sesame oil, some sesames, and a little Hostin sauce. If you want orange wings, you can use the same recipe for a buffalo sauce. Just add the orange marmalade rather than the apricot that I added. And add a little bit more if you want a little bit more orangey. Let's see, what are the barbecue sauce wings? Just add your barbecue sauce at the end. You can either coat them, put them back in the oven, or shake them. I'll show you how I'm going to do mine. And you just substitute your favorite sauce. You know, garlic sauce, garlic butter sauce, there's ranch, blue cheese, you just name it. Anyway, if you like a really good wing place, if you go to Pigeon Forge, Tennessee, there's next to this place we stayed called the Christmas Inn, there's a little place called the Blue Moose, and they have buffalo wings there, and they have every flavor you can imagine, and they are some of the best wings that we've ever had. In fact, we got 50 of them, and we got... Every 10 we got a different sauce on them. So, and they have live music there. It's great. Yep, I'll travel all the way to Tennessee to get buffalo wings. I get wings all over the place. A friend of mine owns a pizza sub and wing shop, and he's from New York. And I did a little work for him doing some flyers and things. And I had the opportunity to work in his restaurant for a little while. So I gathered a few secrets. Okay, you see how they are right now? I'm going to show you how they are. They're not done. If you want to cook them in the deep fryer the whole way, I guess you can. I like finishing them in the oven. So let me grab a pair of tongs here. What we're going to do is we're going to lightly spray this foil-lined pan cookie sheet with just some great value spray. It's no vegetable spray. And we're going to take this, I'm going to put these wings on it. And you've got to be a little careful with them. You don't want to mess up the breading. Aren't they just absolutely stunning? Alright, so we're going to do our second set real quick. Hopefully I got enough light in here today. Alright, so we're going to coat our second set of wings. Oops, gotta drop my basket in first. Because you gotta hold them a second and then drop them so that they don't stick to that basket. That's the secret to anything sticking to the basket. Okay, we're in about 4 minutes. They're getting there. See that? So we got, if you want to cook them the whole way in the deep fryer, turn your oil back a little bit. I got mine set at 370. You can turn your oil back to about 345, 350 and cook them for about 20, 25 minutes and they should be done. But I like baking them. Alright, so there's our 7 minutes. I'm going to go ahead and turn off my deep fryer. Now, if you want to know my oil compound, go to my French fry, the secret of French fry video, and you can see my oil compound. All right, let's move this back over here. Because I'm going to show you one more thing on these wings. Now, I did coat them with a little oil before I fried them. But if you want, you can spray that cooking spray over top of these wings a little bit. I think they will be fine, but I'll show you that just so that you know. Alright, there's our wings. Now, if we wanted to cook those in a fryer, we could have put them right in the fryer for 25 minutes at a slower, at a lower temperature. Alright, so you take your vegetable cooking spray and you just lightly hit them like you're painting. Lightly hit your wings just a little bit. It'll give them that extra little crisp that you need. Okay, they're going in the oven for about 35 minutes and we'll see what they look. I think it's 35 I cook them. At 350 degrees, might be a little longer, might be 45. Turn the light on there. So when we come back, we'll check on those wings. Okay, it's been 15 minutes. Let's just take a look at these wings so I can show you what they look like. There they are. Coming along absolutely beautiful. I'm going to go another 15. Okay, our half hour is up. We're going to take these wings out of the oven here. But we're not quite done yet. Now, if you wanted to serve those up, just breaded wings, I'd let them go another 10 minutes or so because you're going to see what I'm going to do here in a second. I'm going to put them back in. What we're going to do is we're going to take these wings and we're going to coat them with this buffalo sauce. Now, if you wanted to turn these wings over, you can, but when we coat them, we're going to be sticking them back in, so I better grab a pot holder here. Okay, now, I used that Frank's Red Hot Buffalo Wing Sauce this time, but I normally just use Frank's Red Hot, which is original. I didn't see this until I went to the store last time, so I don't know how long that's been out. If you want to take in that sauce and you want to make it more garlicky, you can add minced garlic into that sauce and coat these wings with a little bit more garlic and have garlic buffalo wings, which is, they're pretty good. So we're going to actually take the ladle here and we're going to ladle some of that sauce right across these wings, and we're going to coat them, and then we're going to put them back in the oven . Let's give them a light toss. I want to knock too much of that breading off. Put them right
back on the... Didn't get some of them. Now, like I said, if you want them crisp, you can just cook them a little longer and just put your buffalo wing sauce on them and serve them. Or you can cook them in a deep fryer, just serve them breaded. Use a hot sauce or a wing sauce that you get at the store. You don't have to mix your own. But this is my recipe, and hopefully you'll try it and like it as well. Now, you can use that Hooters wing sauce, a wing breading. I think they even have a wing sauce. I haven't tried their wing sauce. I've only tried the breading. Add a little bit more of this sauce. I think there's enough in there to coat these. Coat them a little bit more. But we're going to put these back in the oven for probably about 10 minutes or so. And then we'll show you these wings. And you can serve them up with a little bit more of this wing sauce, some ranch or blue cheese, some celery sticks. You can do 5, 10, 15 pounds of chicken wings. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. All right, that's 10 minutes back in the oven with that sauce on it. If you wanted to go about 15, it'd even get more crispier, but it's crisped up. Back up to where it was before I put the sauce on it. Now, you're going to have to let these cool a little bit because you don't want to launch into them. It'll burn your mouth. I don't need to tell you that. So anyway, we're going to serve these up with a little ranch. Now, if you spray that right and you coat those wings with a little oil, they're not going to stick. So, you should be good to go. I'm going to put these on a serving tray here. A little bit of ranch. You can put blue cheese. In fact, you can put more of that hot sauce if you like. All right, so you make sure the camera's getting this. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're just going to put some ranch in our little serving container here. All right, now we take the rest of that wing sauce and I put it in a bottle here, and I'm going to stick it back in the fridge because we make wings every single week, so this weekend that'll be good for the wings this weekend. Alright, so there's our shut my oven off. There's our buffalo wings. That's Tom's Manly Mill style. It's Tom's recipe. There's our buffalo wings. Make sure I hold it up here so I can get it for the picture. Alright, we're going to try one of these. You know, I should let it cool, but and dip it in that ranch sauce. Look at that. Woo! That puppy is hot. Where did my fork go? Anyway, clean up my mess here. Alright, let me get another dish, because that thing's a little hot.
As you can see, it's done inside. It's perfect. It's moist. It's got that buffalo sauce. It's got that breading. Oh, that, my friends, is Tom's Manly Meals.
That, I'll put a little bit of that wing sauce on my plate there. That
is buffalo wings. Mmm.
Well,
Tom's Manly Meals, buffalo chicken wings, and my own sauce recipe. I'm talking Tom Moore. And that stuff is hot.
Woo!
See the steam coming off that? Good luck to you.